Rocking Star Yash. Welcome to Film Companion and congratulations on the mind-blowing response to the trailer of KGF. When you dub a film across five languages, you're automatically just increasing the scale and the platform at which it's showcased tremendously. What about KGF made you feel like this had the kind of universal appeal that deserved this platform?
One, the concept of the film, which is very unique, and the way we have shot it, it is very international. And I think it is more than dialogues, it is about the visuals which will narrate the script. Tell you the story. I think cinema has its own language. That cinematic language is very good, and I think it can communicate to each and every person who is watching it. So that's the reason, that's the primary reason. And of course, yes, we truly believe in the script, and we think this is a story which needs to be told to many people. So that's the reason.
It'll also be interesting to know what really were the key takeaways from the stupendous success of a film like Bahubali. What were really the main lessons that you learnt?
It doesn't matter where you come from and what kind of background you have or what kind of an experience or what kind of experience you have. It just depends on how well you're performing and how well you know your job. So theatre is one place where I believe everybody come together. Mm-hmm. They just come under one roof and they just start watching it, and if they connect to it, they will own him. They'll own the actor or they will own the cinema. So I always believe during the promotion it's my film. But once it's released, it won't be my film. People will start owning it and they'll start promoting it. They'll sure. become Yash. So likewise, even the Bahubali, people owned it. That's because they catered it in their respective language. So to an extent where they could understand small things. Other than that, it had a language which I think everybody could easily understand. And the scale and the pride behind that, that people have really worked hard, I think sometimes what I have realized is people give you bigger success just because you have worked really hard. Because a lot of my films with a lot of flaws have done really well because they think, okay, this was a genuine effort and a very honest effort, and they will always appreciate such effort.
Yash, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think in Kannada cinema, it's still Mungaru Mali at 75 crores worldwide. So you haven't really bitten the 100 crore club, or?
Not Mungaru Mali. Mungaru Mali was, it was in 2006, I think. 2014, I had a film called Mr. and Mrs. Ramachari. Yeah. That was the blockbuster till then. And I think the same Humbale Productions, Rajkumara, did better than that. I think close to, we talk about share. We don't talk about the collection. So when we say share, it is what do you take home.
Right.
So that is close to that. But we don't believe in 100 crore club. As he rightly said, it's all about making, you know, reaching it to people, and with the infrastructure what we have got, that is huge. So it's all depends on the infrastructure as well, because see here 3 weeks and the business is gone. The wider the screens, I mean you have large number of screens, there it runs up to 100 days, sometimes 200 days, because that number of audience will definitely come and watch, but it takes time. So if we have a bigger infrastructure, definitely we'd be able to do that. It all depends on the population. See, India is a country which has got more than 100 crores.
Yeah.
So if you see this 500 crore business, whatever you're talking, I don't think it would have even tapped 10 or 15%
no,
of
no.
it. Not
no,
even
25%.
That. Not even that. So it's again, that is not like the ultimate thing. So we have a lot more potential, and it's just about the infrastructure. And the way you keep them
all eyes on
yeah.
KGF. You know, I noticed something really interesting about Kannada film heroes. This is this very exciting tagline that each of you all come with, whether it's rocking star or rebel star or chat. What is this about? What is the story to this? Is it solely fan made? How seriously do you guys take it?
Don't blame me for that. In Hindi, I've strictly told them not to use such things. See, that's something, that's their love and respect. So I would take it with pride there. But I don't want to come and push it here, but I don't know, because of the internet and all, you guys pick it and you guys introduce me like that, but I'm proud of that. But it's not something which we create, it's the fans. Every hero will have at least 5 to 6 such names.
Oh, really?
Okay, yeah. They will have their own fan associations where they will name with their favorite this thing title. And whichever becomes very popular, that producers will pick it and put it on screen. That's kind of marketing thing also. They're trying to say that, yes, this is the star, this is how you want to see, and it just happens like that.
I actually want to talk to you a little bit about Ambareesh and just the fact that you grew up watching and consuming his films, how much has that impacted you as an actor?
No, he was a very big influence in my life since childhood. He was the only actor who we have seen, off screen also.
Yeah.
So he was a very big influence, especially I come from a region where he's very, very popular. So he had a huge influence on my life. After getting into industry also, he was a big support. He was my strength. He was like a father figure. We lost him recently. That was a very, very unfortunate thing. He, in fact, launched our trailer. He had come. He has supported me in every platform. He was there with me. So it's a great loss. Great man. He lived like a king and he went like a king. So he lived his life king size.
Super. Thank you so much for chatting with me, and all the best for the film.
Thank you. Hey guys, this is Yash here. If you like this video, please subscribe to Film Companion.